Make sure that you run that up on there nice and straight.
Which trailer that I'm going to pick to fish on that bait. So out here in the garage, and I wanted to do a video to explain trailer selection and why on a spinnerbait, why I pick which trailer that I'm going to pick to fish on that bait. So spinnerbaits, you know, I think of a few different things when I think of spinnerbaits, but primarily, you know, I've got some colors that are darker colors that I'll use in dirty water on occasion, but if I'm fishing a spinnerbait, man, I'm trying to imitate some type of bait fish. It could be bluegill with some of those darker colors, but most times it's some type of shad or shiner, something that is a light colored bait fish of whatever type that is. But for me, I use two different style trailers on a spinnerbait anymore. I used to use a single tail grub a lot as a trailer, but in those situations where I would have used a grub, I use a small swim bait now, namely a Bass Pro Speed Shad, a 3-inch, or maybe up to a 3.8 if I really want to make a big bulky bait. But typically that little 3-inch Bass Pro Speed Shad is the trailer that I'll use in place of a grub. And the other trailer that I'm going to use is called a Cajun trailer. That's just a split tail style trailer. It's just something that doesn't have a lot of resistance, doesn't have a lot of movement, but it just gives you something a little bit extra for those fish to really key in on hanging there behind, behind the skirt on that spinnerbait. Now, the situations where I'm going to pick one over the other, for me, pretty simple, to be quite honest. I'm going to go with that little boot tail swim bait, that little speed shad, when I'm fishing dirtier water, when I want to have as much vibration, as much bulk, as much movement as possible on that spinnerbait. So it's going to be on those times when I am throwing either a double Colorado or, you know, in our new Terminator Pro Series spinnerbait, it's really a Colorado with kind of an exaggerated Indiana. That is a blade shape that I really, really love for dirty water. But I'm going to use only that little swim bait on the back of that. I'll never use anything else. But one that I'll use both on is actually a Colorado Willa. On that particular spinnerbait, I'll fish it in pretty dirty water, but I'll also fish it in fairly clean water. Just kind of depends on the situation, and that if I want a little bit more thump, if that water's got 18 inches of 2 feet of visibility, I'm probably going to be throwing a Colorado Indiana combination. And if it's a little bit on the dirtier side, I'm likely to go with that speed shad as the trailer. If it's not, you know, if it's a little bit on the clearer side, or I just want the bait to move a little bit faster, then I'm going to use the exact same spinner bait, but just with that Cajun trailer on the back of it. That's the thing to think about with those, the differences between those two trailers as well. Not only does the speed shad have a little bit more vibration, but it also creates a little bit more drag, a little bit more resistance. So if you're wanting to fish the bait faster, that's when you definitely want to go with that Cajun trailer, because it has less resistance to it. And just like the speed shad is the only thing I'll use on the double Colorado, the only thing I'm going to use on a double Willa is going to be that Cajun trailer. So that's something that if I'm throwing a double Willa, it's going to have that Cajun trailer on it. And just to show rigging one up real quick, a big thing with any type of trailer on any type of bait is to make sure that it's going to hang real nice and straight. So with that Pro Series spinnerbait, it's got an excellent trailer keeper on the back of it. So you just want to make sure that you run that up on there nice and straight, and that you run it in there as far as it needs to go. That's kind of, I hold it up there before I actually start seating it onto the hook to make sure just how far I need to come out. But push it up on that trailer keeper there, nice and snug. Straighten it up there just a little bit. But having that trailer rigged on there, you know, perfectly straight is going to not make your spinnerbait roll over anything. And that's the way I rig it too. I don't turn that sideways. Those legs kind of go beside each other in the water, not on top of each other. So that's it rigged up on there. But hopefully this will help you understand which trailer to use in which situation on your spinnerbaits while you're out there fishing.